I was just a child when the stars fell from the skies. But I remember how they built a cannon to destroy them. And in turn, how that cannon brought war upon us. War was an abstract idea, nothing more than a show on TV. As a child, I only saw it as something that happened in some faraway land. Until that final day of summer. One day, while on my way to school, I looked up in the skies. A sound like distant thunder. In the blue skies far above me, contrails drew dizzying circles around in a crazy waltz. A battle in the beautiful skies far away. I could not tear my gaze away from them. Fighters played the cat or the mouse in turn as they climbed swiftly into the sky. One fleeing plane fell out of the skies, spiraling and spewing orange flames to crash by the cape. The same cape where my family lived. Now they only live in my memories of days past. The victor circled around to confirm the kill. And on his craft, there was a large number 13 emblazoned in yellow. I will never forget this. The Allies retreated across the ocean before the onslaught of the enemy. Our little town in the heart of the mainland fell into deep isolation.
After the planetfall of the Ulysses 1994 XF-04 asteroids. Stonehenge, the Erusean weapon of mass destruction, was originally built to shoot down asteroids. Upon discovering its potential as an anti-aircraft weapon, the Erusians ruled the skies over the mainland. The ISAF's attempts to destroy Stonehenge through airstrikes failed. As a result, strategic positions on the mainland were lost. This in turn forced ISAF to evacuate from the east coast to North Point. ISAF GHQ is regrouping its remaining combat forces at North Point. However, the Erusians control most parts of the mainland, and they have forward deployed bombers to Wrigley Air Base, a former ISAF facility. This bomber force will attempt to deal a lethal blow to the ISAF at North Point from this strategic position. Here is the current SITREP and your orders for deployment, effective immediately. Enemy agents destroyed our early warning radar network, allowing several bear bombers to penetrate our airspace. In 15 minutes, we expect this bomber formation to strike Allen Ford Air Base and then move on to targets at North Point. Our air defense forces are extremely weak at this point in time, hence our GHQ is a sitting duck. It is mission critical that you destroy the bombers and neutralize the threat before they get past Newfield Island. Remember, you are the first line of defense for North Point, and the fate of ISAF lies in your hands.
AWACS here, call sign Sky Eye. Do you read? Your call sign is Mobius 1. We'll refer to you by this name at all times. You are now under my command. Six bombers on vector 360 confirmed. Continue north to intercept. Today's my birthday. A victory sure would be nice. Mobius 1, engage.
That. Make sure to thank him.
That's a roundup. Let's go on home.
The war seemed to unfold in the blink of an eye. I don't remember exactly when the forces from the west occupied my town. I was too busy scanning the skies day after day, waiting for Yellow 13 to reappear. Before I knew it, everything changed. The language they taught us at school. Our friendly local sheriff disappeared and was replaced by foreign MPs. In the beginning, some people secretly tuned into broadcasts from North Point on their parabolic antennas. But as time passed, the broadcast no longer came in. Maybe the satellites were destroyed. All non-military computer networks were shut down. Gasoline was rationed to civilians. Though we lived in the 21st century, we were reduced to using crystal radios and horse-drawn carts. I moved in with my uncle in town, who used to be a taxi driver. Out of gasoline and out of work, my uncle did nothing but to drown himself in drink. I earned my keep by playing the harmonica in the town bar. The one thing I was good at. I'd play for sullen occupation soldiers in exchange for their charity and loose change. And use the money to support my uncle and myself. My uncle trash-talked the barkeep who catered to the enemy soldiers. But he never refused the money I brought home. As for myself, I had a crush on the barkeep's only daughter, who was a little older than me. Another day passed, yet still no sign of the fighter plane Yellow 13 in the skies above our town.
The enemy-held Wrigley Air Base is located in close proximity to our front lines, making it the proverbial knife at our throat. A large Erusean bomber contingent was deployed to Wrigley. Their intentions are clear. A full-scale strike on our forces at North Point is imminent. Your mission is to catch these bombers on the ground and destroy them. We intend to turn the parking ramp at Wrigley into a junkyard.
Should be clubbed together. 2. Enemy facility destroyed.
One night, a spirited group made their way up the door, chased out the sullen army grunts, and commandeered the place. Even I knew who they were. The patch on their sleeve was the mark of the proud Air Force. A loud-mouthed, middle-aged man went around, announcing each pilot's results for the day and his running kill record. For those who exceeded 5 kills, a thorough toasting and soaking followed. I believe it was their custom to call a pilot an ace once he shot down 5 planes. After completing the day's review, the same guy, the squadron adjutant, went on to announce, "And now, for our leader's results." Everyone turned around to look at the quiet man who sat alone, strumming a guitar. I found myself drawn to the music from his guitar. Our Yellow 13 bagged 3 more today, bringing his new tally up to 64 kills. With a tentative smile, the man with the guitar turned to me and asked me to accompany him on my harmonica. I brought it up to my lips and I started a new song. I had finally found him. But by some fluke, it was my father's favorite song, the one he used to play at the end of each day.
Survivors are gathering at the northern port of St. Arc. However, the radar facilities atop Mount Shesna provide tactical support to the enemy. As a result, our evac mission is in jeopardy. If our troops can successfully evacuate and regroup at North Point, they will become a formidable force in future battles. Your mission is to destroy the radar facilities on Mount Shesna, thereby blinding the enemy and hiding our troop movements.
to exit combat area and return to base. Fly in the right direction and you'll see a white dotted line across your flight path. Those of you who need to resupply or refuel during missions should cross this line to exit the combat area and return to base or carrier. Approaching return line, follow the controller's orders for landing.
Mobius 1, perform landing check. You are cleared to land. 2 miles to touchdown. You're on the money. Nicely done, Mobius 1. Go and prepare for your next sortie.
We've discovered the Erusians are transporting a large quantity of strategic supplies and rapid deployment troops into Comberth Harbor. Comberth appears to be the staging area for an attack on North Point. The Acre fleet stationed here seems to be the centerpiece of this strike. If the Erusians complete their troop preparations and the Acre fleet sets sail, this will bring about our defeat in this war. Your mission is to intercept and shoot down the enemy transport planes in and around Comberth Harbor. Let's show them how vulnerable they are. Be advised, the transport aircraft have ECMs on board that emit powerful jamming signals. Rely on visual contact rather than radar.
Mobius 1, Sky Eye here. You should be getting visual on the transport soon. Destroy the E-767s hidden nearby to clear the jamming from our radar. Good luck. Mobius 1, engage.
Fox 2! What the? They're gonna blow us out of the sky!
Good job. You shot down the enemy transport without any radar. Operation. Split into two groups and destroy targets. Inflict as much damage as possible to the complex and reduce their output. Do a flyby under the oil rig.
Keep an eye out for Sams.
Heads up, they've got AA guns. Clear to engage. Oil rig at vector 050, 8 miles. Mobius 1, engage.
I've got his tail, he's blind!
Nice kill. Bandit at 2 o'clock.
You're too close! We've got ourselves a dogfight!
Thanks for the save!
Get rid of that chopper, too.
Five million barrels.
One, refining facility destroyed. Switch to attacking the remaining facilities.
Losing their reserves would be a severe blow to them. Radio failure! Being hit?
You're a hotel. I might be item.
highway under construction in a wheat field outside of town. When they started construction, I remember how the mayor bragged about it, even though it would completely bypass our town. The freeway became the occupation force's makeshift runway, and the unfinished tunnels their bunkers. This was their base. They were the elite flight squadron chosen to protect the cannon. Ironically, the same cannon that was created to shoot down the asteroids became a catalyst to the war. But when the Allied attacks no longer came, the squadron was assigned long-range missions that took them to distant battlefields. I thought of the words I would use to confront him and bided my time. Although I harbored these feelings within me, I could never get close to him. His wingman was always by his side. Despite having a gentle demeanor, I could tell that the wingman would never allow danger to get near Yellow 13, even on land. The pillar of their group, 13 exuded an air of invincibility. He always chose to fly a five-plane formation. He was a man who prided himself not on his kill record, but on his record of never losing a squadron member. It's difficult for me to describe just how good Yellow 13's flying was, but I witnessed it once from the ground. The lead plane of the five-plane formation should have turned the same arc with the same timing as the others, yet only his plane drew sharp contrails. His heartfelt compassion towards the weaker enemies he downed. Someday, if an equal appeared and challenged the limits of his skills in a fight, he would bear no resentment about being shot down. He said this himself. And so as time passed, I found the goodness of a home in their company. Leaving them was no longer an option for me now.
Launch a surprise attack on the Aegir fleet while it lies immobilized at Converth Harbor. This large-scale airstrike will be the largest and the most strategic operation since the transfer of HQ to Northpoint. You may need to resupply along the way because this operation will be long in duration. Remember, it is imperative that you complete the mission objective and return to base safely.
Vector 3-4-0. fight. Mobius One, he's on your tail.
Nice kill!
Mobius One, shot one down. Hard enemy radar spike.
You are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius One.
I lost him! 12 o'clock.
Mobius One, you are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions cancelled. Return to your mission, Mobius One.
Enemy missile sunk! The ship's
it.
Fox 2. Enemy facility destroyed.
All evil ships, evacuate the harbor.
Enemy vessel sunk. Sam destroyed.
Mission is to attack the solar power generator plants in the Faith Park region. These generators equal nuclear ones in output and provide about 60% of the energy for the Erusean's military-industrial complexes. Since they do not require oil or uranium supplies, we cannot stop power production by interdicting their supply lines. This deep strike mission will not only cripple the Erusean's industrial output, but also divert attention from our own imminent invasion plans.
Use the solar panels as markers and proceed due north to the power plant. Don't let the enemy spook you. Solar power generator plant at vector 020, 4 miles.
The co-op ahead is our target, the power plant.
He's behind me. Enemy facility destroyed.
Drag him this way.
Die, you SOB!
I'm right behind him.
to 180 and head south to base. 10 seconds to impact.
Omega 11
crashed! All aircraft prepare for impact.
At some point, I realized my uncle, my would-be guardian, had vanished. Maybe the secret police dragged him off for some drunken comment he made. Maybe he chose to disappear. I didn't have anyone to turn to, so I found myself living as if I were a member of the Yellow Squadron. Everybody in town scorned the barkeep for doing business with the enemy. In reality, he and his family were members of the resistance, gathering up intelligence information from enemy customers. His daughter protected me. But that was only because of my tender age. The barkeep and his family were the real heroes, while I, on the other hand, found a haven among the enemy.
Satellite will be launched from the Kimona Highlands rocket base to support our mainland operations. The Erusians responded by deploying a large number of their air superiority fighters to prevent the launch. A large-scale air battle is expected. We must win this battle to maintain our air superiority. We've only got one window of opportunity for this launch. Shoot down as many fighters as possible to preserve top cover over the rocket base.
Thank you. 2. Box 2.
Mobius 1, get out of there!
Check 6.
Jake, right! I've got his tail, he's flying!
Missile shot trashed. Bandit closing at 6. Radar lock.
Radio failure! Thanks for the save. Now! Damn, incoming missile! Nice speed again, we make it home alive.
Locked on.
Right on Nova! Mobius 1, he's on you! Turn hard! Mobius 1, they had an RTL! Turn hard!
Sky High here. Intercept them before they reach the launch site.
Negative contact, nothing on my radar.
Look harder. The B-2s are difficult to detect on radar. They're stealth.
Are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius One.
To launch.
40,000 feet. It is now immune to enemy action. Thanks to you, the launch was a success.
It won't be long now. It won't be long till it begins. The barkeep's daughter confided to me. As a member of the resistance, she eagerly awaited the Allied counterattack on the mainland. What will happen to these people when the Allies come? I asked, to which she frowned. We'll run them out. This is our town. But I knew she didn't mean that from the bottom of her heart. 13 had captured her heart. I knew this from the way she shot jealous glances at his wingmen. As other pilots rotated out of Yellow Squadron, Yellow 4, 13's wingman, always stuck by his side, even on land. The only female pilot in the squadron, she had Yellow 13's absolute trust as his wingman. Yellow 13 seemed oblivious to all this, and instead reviewed the promising enemy pilot's performance from yesterday's skirmish. He's so close. If he manages to stay alive for just a while longer, that pilot could be a worthy opponent. But when there were no such enemies to look forward to, 13's eyes were sad.
The troops are regrouped and ready to reclaim lost territory from the Erusians in the amphibious Operation Buckershot. The plan requires our forces to follow an extremely narrow and vulnerable path from the landing site to the inland objective. This path allows the enemy to concentrate their fire and provides them with a distinct advantage. However, this route lies out of Stonehenge's effective range. Your mission is to reduce troop casualties at the beach landing sites.
Engage. Enemy tanks destroyed!
Mobius 1, Box 2. Enemy vehicle destroyed. It'll be hard to provide supporting fire with this low visibility. Enemy bombardment has ceased. We can move now. It's no good. They're still in the water. The second landing party is coming. Move forward. Clear the beach. Enemy facility destroyed. Surface target destroyed.
You are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius 1.
Don't stop there! You'll be caught in the... LA-10s. Unit B appears to have secured Crown Beach.
10-4, good job. The mission is a success. Unit B Commander, didn't you have some message for the pilots?
This is Sergeant Collins. I've taken over command of Unit B. Tell them thanks for the supporting fire.
Roger, this is headquarters. Mission complete.
The Tango Line is a vital line of defense for the Erusean forces on the eastern mainland. Istis Fortress is a strategic foothold on that line. It utilizes unique terrain features that make it virtually impregnable. Support our troops by attacking and neutralizing the combat power of Istis Fortress. Be forewarned, this will put you within range of Stonehenge. However, your skills should prove to be more than a match for it.
Inside Stonehenge's engagement zone. Be careful, they may shoot.
They've got the advantage, so stay focused.
Scion Airbase, the Vector 070, 12 miles. No worries, just proceed as usual. Mobius 1, engage.
How many made it out of the airbase up there?
Enemy facility destroyed.
I've lost contact with base. What's the status?
Behind you. Mobius 1, bandit on your tail. Turn hard. Turn left. Turn left.
6.
Cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius One.
Mobius One, Box Two.
Right.
Bandit confirmed at Vector 130. Bandit confirmed at Vector 290.
Destroyed. Get moving. Their bombing's very effective.
Let's flank him.
One shot, one down.
Thanks for the save.
Mobius, one shot, one down. Damaged. Our troops should face minimal resistance. Mission complete. All aircraft RTB.
Two civilian aircraft flying through the hills region northwest of Los Canas are under threat of attack by Erusean fighters. On board are the engineers responsible for Stonehenge, as well as their families. They are offering information in exchange for amnesty and permission to defect to an ISAF member state. One of the aircraft is flying at an extremely low altitude due to some unknown problem. Your mission is to protect both aircraft from enemy fighters. Make sure they exit the combat area safely.
Erusea, this is Sky Eye. Please describe your situation.
Erusea, Flight 702 here. Erusean fighters are closing in on us at 23,000 feet. Please hurry.
Flight 701 here. We were shot on takeoff and our captain's injured. This is First Officer Nagase.
10-4, an escort is inbound. Both aircraft maintain your course.
This is Flight 702. The ISAF plane has the Erusians tied up. We just may make it.
Mobius 1, there's another bandit closing in on Flight 701 at 6,000 feet. Flight 701, can you raise altitude? This will assist the ISAF escort.
Negative. We cannot maintain cabin pressure if we climb.
Bombs were delivered to their base. This meant that an enemy who had to be fought by those means was close at hand. The resistance blew up the squadron's runway. Yellow 4 suffered light shrapnel wounds. Though the runway could be fixed, the complete loss of reserve supplies was a heavy blow. Logistics support became infrequent following the Allied operations. I knew this because Yellow Squadron's crew chief bellyached about this all the time to me. I won't complain if I buy the farm while I'm airborne, but I can't stand being taken out while I'm grounded. Now I understand 13's feelings. Reports of the Stonehenge air raid came in. Yellow 4 ran up with others. With no bombs, her plane was light. But her plane was in bad shape. It needed an engine replacement badly.
We will attack Stonehenge, the lethal weapon that has plagued ISAF for so long. Since it was designed to shoot down asteroids, a few small fighters flying unpredictable high-speed courses should be able to get within range. According to the defectors, its central ECM jamming system disrupts our radar and missile guidance systems. Unless this system is destroyed, our mission will be very difficult to execute. HQ predicts a 40% casualty rate for all deployed aircraft. It'll be a tough mission, but one we can't avoid. Now go and reclaim the skies over the mainland. Dismissed.
Target is neutralized.
destroyed the target.
Holy! Yahoo!
One. The other aircraft are withdrawing. That's a confirmed kill on a yellow. It's a complete victory for the good guys.
Though he lost 4, 13 never openly showed his sorrow. But I found out. He was alone, quietly gazing at the handkerchief Yellow 4 left behind. When he felt my eyes upon him, he said, "No matter what, she can't complain. She went up with her plane in disrepair. Pilots are responsible for their planes." He then went on and spoke of the time when they first met. He spoke of when she was just a girl, before he trained her, before she became a fighter pilot. His words weren't directed at me in particular. He was keeping a precious memory alive by speaking those words. The hint of perfume on her keepsake handkerchief. Yellow Squadron's pilot turnover ran high. The skilled ones went in to shore up other units while rookies with little airtime transferred in. Yellow 13 posted an allied paper faxed over by headquarters. It praised the pilot who destroyed Stonehenge. 13 said to everyone, "Look, here's something worthy of praise. Even among the enemy there are men like this. Not all of them are despicable bastards who rob our wings through cowardly sabotage." I stared at the barkeep's daughter as she winced at those words. The Allies were coming to our town.
Here's an air airship jamming device. There are others as well. Destroy them all.
This is Leopard flying north of Gnome Ravine. Are the jammers disabled yet, Sky-Eye?
ISAF will handle the jammers. Maintain your course and we'll get you home safe.
Roger, we're in your hands.
Thank you.
all bandits and protect the reconnaissance aircraft.
Out of commission, the landing operations are underway in the northern part of the mainland. In response, the Erusians have launched large numbers of cruise missiles against the ISAF landing forces. Our radar is unable to pick up these missiles that fly at ultra-low altitudes. Failure to destroy these missiles will put our troops in danger. Your mission is to shoot and destroy each and every cruise missile.
Mobius 1, a wire from the northern landing forces. We're depending on your efforts. Commence operation. Don't let any escape. Target is closing in on the landing site. Clear to engage. Mobius 1, engage. Down. a direct hit. What an explosion. Mission complete. The landing forces saw from below, and they extend their thanks.
As the Allies advanced, the retreating Erusean forces from the east filled our town. The AA gun crew set up their positions atop the hospital, and Yellow 13 smoldered with quiet anger over their tactics. Nights were long, with the town's mandatory blackouts. The barkeep's daughter tried to plant laser transmitters for detonating explosives. She got caught. It was Yellow 13. He knew she was responsible for planting the bomb on their runway as well. The face of the enemy, whom he hated, belonged to someone close to him. "Get out of our town, you fascist pig." Those were the words from my mouth. I've never seen his face twist so painfully. "Do you hate us that much?" We couldn't shake or nod our heads in reply. It seemed like an eternity passed before he said go and released us. The next day, there was no change in his attitude. As usual, he made his requests to the squadron crew chief. "The poor fuel quality is affecting thrust." As soon as the Allied forces drew near, the resistance would end the blackouts over the city.
Was a neutral city at the start of the war until the Erusians occupied it. We will now liberate this city. The heaviest resistance will come from the tank battalion near Route 7 in Old Town, and the anti-tank helicopters near the new city government complex. In addition, you must defend our allies from any airstrikes that may originate from the airport behind you. The resistance fighters will end the blackout over the city. Suppress all enemy resistance and help liberate the city.
Mobius 1, Sky Eye here. The resistance just ended the blackout. Commence operations. Sweep out all enemy forces in Old Town, New City, and the airport.
Still no joy.
Government complex, Vector 320, on the nose. Clear to engage. Mobius 1, engage.
We've lost contact with Bravo 6.
Fox 2, Fox 2.
Yee-hoo!
Chopper shot down.
Various explosions and reports from the fighters can be heard.
Enemy vehicle destroyed.
It is now 12.05 a.m. Usea Central Mean Time. Fighting has broken out despite the hour.
Don't sweat! Here goes one away!
We apologize for the momentary disruption of this live broadcast.
Turning hard right.
Bandit at 6 o'clock!
destroyed.
Just a little more.
Enemy facility destroyed. Surface target destroyed.
Secured.
Enemy facility destroyed. Mobius 1, Sky Eye here. The airport has been neutralized. Flow to support other areas.
Shoot him off me! Now!
Mobius 1, you are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius 1.
gathering on the highway.
Mobius 1 shot down a target. Blackjack shot down.
In charge of censoring broadcasts has evacuated as well. Now we can shout victory is ours. Andrei Wolski reporting for community broadcast.
Singing. The town was free at last. During the night raids, the AA gunners had strafed the town in an attempt to shoot down low-flying aircraft. The town militia now rounded up these gunners. They retreated as well, and now their quarters stood empty. After what seemed like a long absence, Allied aircraft soared overhead. I wondered if the fateful enemy ace, the one that Yellow 13 longed to meet, was on the move. What would happen if they ever came face to face? I fell in with the routed Erusians and followed after the squadron.
Whiskey Corridor is a narrow strip of land between Lambert and Amber Mountains. The enemy has deployed a large tank force at the end of the corridor as its final line of defense. Despite being outnumbered, our allies must face this enemy contingent head-on in order to advance on the Erusean capital of Barbanti. Our projected casualty rate is extremely high. We need a miracle in air support to win this battle. Annihilate enemy ground forces and provide direct close air support to our troops.
Attention all aircraft, this is Sky Eye. This is primarily a ground battle, so our duty is to provide close air support. Destroy as many enemies as possible to assist our troops' forward movement.
Engage.
get hit. Fox 2. Tank destroyed. Enemy vehicle destroyed.
Erusean forces 4 miles ahead of us. There's three, and then there are four cars.
Enemy facility destroyed. Facility destroyed.
Mobius 1, you are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius 1.
Destroyed. Mission complete. All aircraft RTB.
The enemy GHQ is located beneath a landfill on the coast of their capital, Barbanti. Bring it under control to end this war once and for all. Our troops will enter via the Silver Bridge to the southeast and the Flooded City to the south. You must attack all enemy forces and support our troops. Enemy tank forces are also closing in from the north. Destroy Johnson Memorial Bridge to stop them from joining forces from the enemy GHQ. We know that Megalith is being developed as we speak. The enemy must be prevented from using it as their last-ditch effort.
The outcome of the war rests on you, so stay focused on what's at hand. Remember, survival is paramount. Good luck to you all, and Mobius 1, an end to the war. Birthday gift as well. Mobius 1, engage. Mobius 1, Fox 2.
Mobius 1, you are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission, Mobius 1.
Once and for all, leave the choppers to the others. You can end this war. Clear to engage.
Mobius 1, incoming missile!
landed at 12 o'clock. Radar lock. Mobius 1, box 2. Missile shot trashed. Locked on. Mobius 1, box 2. Missed. Shot down the 5 aircraft that appeared. Air superiority is ours. You made it through alive, Mobius 1.
Yellow 13's body vanished into the blue skies, never to return to Earth. Only a single handkerchief fluttered down from the sky where he disappeared. The faint scent of perfume. The barkeep's daughter and I had followed the squadron this far. Each of us had our own thoughts as we buried that handkerchief. It no longer mattered to me whether that was 13 or 4's grave. Their memories blurred together as one, and left the realm of reality like a dream. The terms of surrender were accepted that day, and the war was over.
A group of young Erusean officers have taken over Megalith, the superweapon that was under development. Megalith is a rocket launch facility that can shoot down asteroid fragments in orbit. The only way to destroy this highly dangerous and fortified facility is to hit it from the inside. Follow the missile port grooves to find the 3 generators deep within the facility. Destroy the generators to access the central heat vent. Once inside, destroy the giant missile in the central silo. An infiltration unit will secure your escape route. Their plan calls for waiting until the generators are offline, and then taking over the sub-control room once the blackout hits. Enter this rat's nest with full confidence that the unit will get you out again. It's highly likely that this will be your final mission. Remember, we need heroes after the war too. Make it back in one piece. Dismissed.
Fox 2! do something. Pull back! Pull back! Leave him, he's dead!
Fox 2! Fox 2!
Don't let those pilots die.
The once familiar scent of burning jet fuel has long since faded away. What was once Yellow Squadron's runway is now just a local highway again. I write this letter to you now. I know it must have brought him unexpected joy to have an opponent like you at the end of that meaningless war. At least that's what I want to believe. Only you, the pilot who shot him down, can confirm this. And so, I write to you.